Prime Minister Gordia.
Thank you.
Yeah, we've got a photo op.
Small talk.
E purtroppo la civiltà dell'immagine che impone le sue regole.
La vostra stampa.
Dov'è?
Thank you. Well.
Does it hurt the Democrats and help the Republicans?
I'd rather not comment.
Well, Mr. President, do you think committing adultery should disqualify somebody from this high office?
I'm sure they will.
How do you think they'll decide?
I'm not going to make a guess.
Lights, please. Thank you.
This way, please.
Thank you.
parte per la sinistra, per piacere, Michele.
Yeah.
Prime Minister, my name is Howard Bake. Glad to know you.
Press was finished with us, and then I took him all the way into the room across the hall where we're going to have lunch. Suddenly realized I'd left something out. Well, I had promised that I would give a readout on the summit meeting that we've just held here, and some impressions of mine before we get underway with all the other subjects of interest to us. Gorbachev is confident. He's not like a leader under fire, even though we've heard that he's having troubles there with some of his programs. But then I guess we never can be sure of what's going on in Kremlin. We had about 5 hours of one-on-one meeting, and I think the talks were cordial, but we were both very candid. The INF Treaty, I think, sets a precedent. It's actual reductions of weapons, not just limitations on how many more we're going to have. And I think also we set a new pattern with regard to the verification, that it is the strongest, I think, that has ever been invoked on any treaty that we have with. And the INF treaty, I think, shows the success of the alliance solidarity. It's crucial now that our Senate will ratify that treaty and as quickly as we can get it done. So when you have meetings with some of our congressional leaders, I will be most grateful if you will state to them your support of that treaty and belief in its ratification. Then the other possibility of a treaty, what we call START, the Strategic Arms Treaty, where we're calling for a 50% reduction in the intercontinental ballistic missiles. And we're hopeful will be taken up in a subsequent summit in the Soviet Union, but we did make some progress. We developed counting rules and an outline there of a sweeping verification. I think one thing that shows that we were holding our own is the fact that on a discussion of sublimits on warheads, we had a figure that we had wanted to bring them down to 4,800, and they had a figure of 5,100, and so we negotiated from those 2 points, and we settled on 4,900. Did a little better than they did in the Hagel there. Now, SDI, our Strategic Defense Initiative, rhetoric was changed a little bit from the tactics. Their goal is the same. They would like to cripple SDI while they continue with what we know they've been doing with regard to defense programs for a number of years. But we're holding firm, and I will not agree to that, to the compromise of SDI. I think that I know that you've made a statement in regards to what I would like to explain on the Strategic Defense Initiative. We're embarked on research to see if we cannot find, and it looks very favorable, we've made some breakthroughs, that we can actually, if not totally, at least in the main, be eliminated.
Before we sit down, what he said, anyone wants to
He's washed, so he's all set.
We have some little green problems.
How is Mr. Prime Minister? How is President Putin?
Problem with his health.
Plus,
he must consider his age.
It's
always the same.
Just made a great impression.
Yes.
And sympathy
has a great, sympathy.
That I believe is my mind.
That's right.
It's too much to
do. No, it's
not.
More than that,
have the mind of having one picture.
First time I've ever eaten on this.
Mr. President, this is the room where I have my 8 o'clock meeting, staff meeting every morning. And I must say this certainly did improve the ambience.
I didn't know that. I always thought it was in your office.
No, sir. We will have another one in there at 8:30, but the staff meeting is here at 8 o'clock.
That painting of Theodore Roosevelt, you know, the famous charge up San Juan Hill in Cuba at the time of that war, when that was done. He was the only one who went up the hill on horseback. The enemy fire was so great that they dismounted the cavalry, and everyone was on foot so they could, you know, hit the dirt, take shelter and so forth. but he believed that he had to be visible to his men and to encourage them. So he made himself the target. He was out there on horseback. I don't know how he ever avoided getting shot.
I'm glad you haven't faced a similar situation, Mr. President.
Expression on his face. That is an arrogant expression.
Oh my God.